What's up, everyone? It's KK here, and welcome back to Master Throne Top 4 for PlayStation 2. This is going to be Race 636 in Season 1 Career Mode, the Food Save 500, so let's get into it. I gotta put in the chassis, the engine, and the body, like I always do, and it's always opposite of what's being repaired, so without further ado, let's get into qualifying. After four, first lap is 16:11. This one should be a little better. It's not. God, I wish it was a little better. 40th, and we're freaking starting the outside. That's not good at Bristol. At least in this version of Bristol. The Bristol now, I can like run the high line and it's whatever. I need to loosen up the car. It's bad. I need to loosen up a little bit. So, alright, let's get this race underway.
Welcome, everyone, to Bristol, Tennessee, for today's NASCAR Winston Cup race, the Food City 500. This place has been referred to as the world's fastest half-mile oval. Add 43 cars to that, and you've got a recipe for some exciting racing.
A lot of these teams don't like coming here too much. There isn't a whole lot of room out there, which usually leads to a week of work in the body shop. There probably won't be a single car at the end that doesn't at least have a scratch or two, and some will be much worse than that.
Tony Stewart has had an amazing string of qualifying runs this year.
Yeah, that team has made great strides in improving their qualifying setups, and it shows with all the top 10 starts they've made.
David Green will begin the race in the top 5 in points.
Gaining on the leader is tough when you're in the top 5 in points. It takes you having a good race and the leader having a bad one in order to gain anything substantial.
The 83 car is having some trouble in the points this year.
Well, there's always going to be someone who has to fill in the bottom of the points list. Of course, none of these guys want to ever see their names there. Sometimes it's just not your season to shine.
I never thought here that a Bush driver was top 5 in points, but in this game, like, what is this? This season, in particular, has been crazy already. Only 5 races in, coming to 6th race.
Now, let's take a look at the starting lineup. Starting out front are the Motorcraft 4 and the Pfizer 4. Starting in row 2, Sharpie 4.
the 16th row are the UPS Ford and the UAW Delphi Chevrolet. In the 17th row are the BAM Racing Dodge and the 57 car. In the 18th row are the 27 car and the David Green Pontiac. Starting the race from row 19 are the 22 car and the Haviland Dodge.
Everyone's back here seems like they should belong, so let's go. I couldn't even make the start finish line without having that happen. Oh goodness, I made this car way too loose now. I think it made his car way too loose. I wanted to loosen up, I think it made it way too loose now. I'm gonna have to fix that before I pit. Because I can't do it on pit road fast enough. The pit road's too short. The length of pit road is way too short for that to make it work. Oh my god, this car sucks. I can't wait for Talladega. That's when I'm gonna actually get some useful cash and do some stuff. Ah! Goodness gracious, Jerry Nadu, I know you want to get going, because you probably shouldn't belong back in 41st, but seriously, I need to... Oh my goodness, this car... Oh no, 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 hang on, Biffle, no! Okay. Ah! Hang on, oh my goodness. No, we're last now. This car is too loose for me to drive. Maybe I'll feel better as the run wears on, but for now, this car is not gonna go where I want it to. At this point, I'm hoping for a big wreck. And someone blew up already. Great. Thank you. Who's that? Oh, rival Jeff Green. Cool. Of all the drivers, my rival had to call it a day six laps in. Not even six laps in. His pit box isn't even at the start. Isn't even before start finish line, or after start finish line. So there he is. Unless I want to run to the back of this car as I enter pit road, I'm not going to because. Oh my god. I took my eyes off for a second. That happened. Great. I'm way behind these guys. I took my eyes off the track for a second, that's what happens. Oh, Mark Martin, hi. Yeah, go on. I don't want to hold you up as leader. You know, I probably should have tried to extend a lead lap. It wasn't going to happen anyway. I mean, what the heck? Only 10 laps and you already lapped me. I already got lapped. These guys are so much faster than me right now, it's embarrassing. This is going to take at least 3 seasons to even make it to Championship 4, I mean, maybe 4 or 5. That's how bad I'm running right now. And I can't get enough cash in the bank to, like, upgrade, get, like, new parts or whatever, or even overhaul my stuff. That's how bad it is right now for me. I can't wait for Talladega. Hopefully I actually get a really good run there, and then I can get some decent amount of cash, try to get a shop dish in or overhaul some stuff. That'd be great. No, 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 no. Loose, loose, loose. Ricky Craven in top 5. Hi. Ow. Not anymore, Did that not count for anything, or... That did nothing. I bumped him like 4 or 5 times, and I have nothing yet. He's nothing. Unbelievable. The one good thing about this race right now is that I won't finish last. However, I'm so far behind right now that it does not even matter.
Is
And this is why I want to go super speedways over and over and over again, because this car sucks. On short tracks, I can't wait for Texas. That's probably one of my favorite tracks in this game. As long as I can run decently. Texas is wide enough where you can do that. Three wide in the middle of a freaking Everham sandwich there for 2 seconds because Mayfield decided to dive bomb turn one.
Man, dive bomb.
This is gonna be like the whole race, just getting passed by everyone on the outside right now. And there's points leader Stewart, who's, I don't think he's in the top 10 actually. That's a first. Ah, I'm around. Great. It might be time for you to shut up. Why would the game make me back up like that, right back on a track like that? That is ridiculous. I'm pitting. I need to pit. I can't do this. I can't do this. The car's way too loose at the start, and that's why I couldn't get going. And now, I might get lapped a second time now while I'm on pit road. We'll see. If nothing else, I just want to finish this race. I knew I wasn't going to look forward to this race at all. Got a lot of damage on the car too. The left front is pretty much caved in, I guess, from hitting that inside wall. Oh, so now the pick who's faster. Why couldn't you do that the last couple of races, damn it? Here comes pace car. Hurry up. Hurry, 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 hurry.
Hurry up. Nice work, bud. But you'll have
mail. I know. Come on. We're good. Thank God. Alright, so we're still a lap down, but we have a chance, I guess, to do something. I'd be a little shocked if we made 29 laps of fuel, but I'd like to try, just because I want to see if it works. Because these guys are just pitting right now. Bobby Bonnie and some of these other guys, they're pitting right now. So we could try, I guess, as long as we don't spin out or get ran in the back by someone like Ricky Craven. That's finally minus 30. I was debating on whether up the air pressure, high pressure or not, and I decided to on yes because I really should anyway. Oh my goodness, this car. Yeah, at this point, I'm just trying to make enough fuel from here. I can't do anything. I don't want to pit again. Who knows, if I'm lucky, I might be able to actually get a win in the stupidest way ever. If I win like this, that's going to be the stupidest thing I've ever seen in my life. Because honestly, I shouldn't even be close to winning a race yet. Oh no! Do not hit McMurray. That was so damn close. McMurray gone by me. Jeez. I almost ruined it again by getting LePage the second time. Got LePage on Mike Scarrell. He was hanging in the pit road. Now I almost got LePage by McMurray as he was coming out of pit road. Goodness gracious. That would have been super terrible. Alright, Terry Levani. Just going by. I can't do anything right now. I'm in the top 10. That's first. I'm literally having to hit neutral as I cross, before I even cross the start finish line, like even halfway down the straight. That just sucks. I can't even deal with 120. Benson! Hello! I'm going right outside and we got caution. Great. That's one time where I wish the Warburton glitch didn't happen. God damn it. Now I'm gonna pit. I need to pit. I can't not pit at this point in the race. I mean, I'm gonna get destroyed if I stay out. So I'm gonna pit again and get some fresh tires and fuel. Enough fuel to make it to the finish. I need the fuel, for sure. And just a few laps on these tires with this car is bad enough, so I need to pit. God, I wish I had, like, better setup for recording this stuff sometimes, because you can hear background stuff all the time now. And you're hearing outside garbage disposal stuff. It's ridiculous. Okay. And we're good to go. Shouldn't even be close, getting lapped, and we're out. Nice. Alright.
Nobody else decided to come in.
We're fourth. We're out of all the positions we could be in, we're fourth, and Robbie Gordon's leading. Wait, are we seriously? We're still a lap down. Darn it. I didn't realize we were still a lap down. Well, if a caution comes out, we're next in line to get a lap back, at least, so that's good. I think, never mind. Who the heck is leading? I don't even know who's leading at this point. But somehow we're gonna be fourth right now. Ow. Elliot Sadler. Making a lot of rivals this race. Because they're running the back of me and whatever. Ricky Rudd's next in line to pass me. Rusty Wall. Everyone's a lap down at least. This is ridiculous. Who is the leader? I would love to know who's leader. Because it's not Robbie Gordon, obviously. I thought it was, but it's not. It's someone else entirely. I don't know who. We're dropping spots now. I just realized that. We dropped a spot to... I didn't even notice that Ricky ran past us, so... At this point, I gotta try to hold off some of these guys, because I don't know who's for position, who's not. I know Harvick is. He's right there behind me. I kinda wanna just hang on to the top 10 at this point. Ah, no, Harvick! Oh, thank you! He spun me and then he saved me. That was like New Hampshire with Dale Jr. all over again. Oh no, in the wall. Okay, I'm just gonna try to finish this race because that's all I need to do is finish high up in the spot in the standings right now. I dropped back to 10th already. Great. Doesn't matter as long as I finish this damn race and not DNF. If I can finish in the top 10, I can't. I don't think I'll be able to because Ken's right on me and he's trying to pass me for position. But if I finish like top 10 or top 20, even top 20 would be nice. That'd be nice. I haven't gotten a top 20 since Daytona. That's the worst. That's the craziest part about it. I didn't think Kenza was. I thought Kenza was going to go a little lower at least, and he didn't. That's stupid. Jack Sprague is not for position, so whatever. Be a blocker for me, thank you. Newman's not for position either. My goodness. It's crazy. Some of these guys aren't for position. Craven and Billy right behind Mark Martin, they're for position. It'll last for another 7 laps, because, or six, maybe 6, because I don't think I'll be able to finish 7 laps without getting lapped again. Oh, no. Okay. Warburton actually ruined my chance of winning this race, which is actually good, because I shouldn't be winning at this point in the season, this point in career mode. But top 15, top 20, that'd be nice. I couldn't even get a top 15 at Daytona, so that'd be nice to get a top 15, if nothing else. Nope, that's not happening. How I got it's happening now. If I can hold off Jerry Mayfield back there, fourth car back behind me, I can hang on a top 15. I hope the leader laps us, because I want to see who the hell is leading this whole race by an entire lap or so. Don't spin out. Thank you, Dave Green, for helping me out there. And Mayfield's gun right for our back bumper. And he's past us now. No, wait, I'm fighting back off two. Ah, it's loose. Never mind. No, on the brake. Okay, we're good. That could have been a hell of a lot worse. I think Rusty Wallace actually got back on the lead lap, so that's great. Ah, no. White flag. I think it's either Junior or Burton. I can't tell who it was. Oh my goodness. But I'm gonna come away with what looks like a 16th place finish. Thank the heavens, I can't believe it happened. And Jeff Burton won. He lapped everyone but one car. Rusty Wallace got back on the lead lap.
We usually have more cautions than that, don't we?
I can assure you, all those guys who finished in the back would have liked to see more cautions. Gives them a chance to make adjustments without the penalty of going a lap down. They just didn't have the luxury this time.
We hope you enjoyed today's race as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. We'll see you next week at Texas.
Oh my goodness, that crazy race is over. I can't fathom how much I'm glad I'm done with this race. Even with the 16th place finish I got, I'm just glad it's over. That's really all I can say about it. Alright, let me see this. Burton won, he led 19 laps, is that most laps led? No, someone else led more laps than that. Rusty lost like 5. Rudd led a lap off the pole, Rod Gorman led a lap. Gorman led 2. Someone had to lead the rest of those laps. There we are, 40th to 16th, that's crazy. And we finished higher than McMurray, awesome. Wait, did we get rookie the... We probably got rookie the race honors too, I'm surprised. Let's see, who is that we just saw? That was Mark Martin, led 22 laps and finished 2 laps down. Oh my goodness, some of these guys finished 4 laps down and Jeff Green went home early. Alright, let's go check, let's go down here. Next race is Texas, I'm looking forward to it. It's a wide and fast race track and I like going on that track a lot. Okay, I can't fix that yet, so... Okay, I can fix this one though. Can we overhaul? No, it still costs too much, let's prepare for one race. And we'll repair this for one race as well, I guess. Yeah, it's one race. That's good that it's one race now for those two. We're actually losing cash every race now because I think the team I have now is just it's too fast now and I can't exactly produce finishes. I can't wait for Talladega. I've lost money since before Bristol, I had more money before Bristol, so that's looking good now. Stewart's still leading by a lot. 4 out of 6 races, it's ridiculous. If he wins Texas or Talladega, I'm gonna hate it. Oh man, we jumped up to 34th in points, so that's good. We're still a long way behind McMurray though. He's still like at least 100 something points ahead of us. Yeah, 180 I'd say. 80 or so points, so still a long way to go to get to him at least. So, we got picking up place and rookie of the race, so that's pretty crazy. We got 2 awards from Bristol. That's the first award we've gotten since Daytona. Well, we're still a long way behind the McMurray rookie of the year. I don't think I'll get that. Have we led any laps? No, we haven't. Okay. Alright, well, I'll see you guys for Texas, for the Samsung Radio Shack 500. It's been fun racing Bristol, but that was a nightmare, honestly. But finished 16th, I'm okay with that. I'll see you guys in Texas.